Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team. And today, we are going to be exploring two different tools we can utilize to keep our models organized. Design organization is an important part of effective productivity. In this video, we are going to specifically dive into how we can use Group Edge and Group Body to quickly make design changes. We are beginning with this copy machine, and we will start by taking a look at the inner assembly that contains the tamper. Specifically, we are going to investigate this plate on the outside, which helps hold the subassembly together. The first thing we will look at is how we can make changes to the edges of these holes along the outside of the plate. If we go to the part navigator, we can see that these holes were created from the pattern face tool with an extrude. The important thing to notice is that when these holes were created, they didn't use the actual hole command from NX. Because of this, the entry and exit chamfers can't be as quickly changed to fit our design needs. We can fix this by using the Group Edge tool found in the Home tab under the Feature Tools section. The Group Edge tool allows edges to be grouped and used as input for downstream feature operations. Once finished, we can now find the Group Edge within our Part Navigator. This is what we will select when we are prompted for inputs down the line. Now, we can begin to see how the Group Edge plays into our workflows. If we go to the Edge Blend command and select our Group Edge as the input, the part quickly updates to reflect the blend on all four edges. If we go back to our subassembly and instead decide a chamfer is more appropriate, we can easily adjust the changes by deleting our edge blend and using the group edge as our input in the chamfer command. The group edge tool is much more useful on large scale projects, but it is clear the difference that it can make. The other tool we are going to look at is the group body command. Similar to group edge, this command allows us to capture a number of bodies and groups them to be used as inputs for downstream feature operations. To look at the group body command, we're going to look at a different part of the coffee machine. This time, we will explore the display screen and the pins that are on the back. To save time, I have already created our group using the group body command, but the interface is the same as group edge was. When I highlight the command in the part navigator, you can see the pins on the left side are selected. Although it's convenient to differentiate the pins from the screen itself, for prototyping purposes, it might be better to connect them all as one piece. If we go to the Unite command and select the group body as our tool, we can quickly make this part of the assembly one piece. This is a great way to keep your assembly organized when the part navigator begins to get cluttered. In conclusion, in this video, we discussed two important tools for design organization. We began by looking at the group edge command, creating edge blends and chamfers quickly to adjust for design needs. And we wrapped things up by looking at the group body command, watching how the pins of the screen could be united with the rest of the subassembly. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.